How you doing? So I decided to do everything in my room. I did it downstairs, now I'll do it up here. So this whole Weil McLean boiler, as you know, was taken out. That white stuff there, that's asbestos. I kept it in a jar and sealed the top. There's actually, let me open it up and move the fan. There's actual charcoal from the 1940s. You know, probably from the 1940s. And it just comes out of the earth because it's lighter. So when it rains hard, it just comes out. So there's a lot of spillage when these people are delivering coal to the house to be burnt. You know, this is the original thing. I cleaned it up. Wonderful company. I just didn't know that the asbestos product was so bad. So when the crew removed it from the basement, they actually left chunks out in the backyard and stuff. Totally screwing up everything. Not good. I don't know, I could be breathing in all the time. I don't know. This thing's pretty cool too. Not that. The biggest chunk of aluminum that I have. It's actually a heat sink. Everything is attached to the back. And all the heat that's generated off of that amplifier goes out the fins, protecting the whole system. I've never have seen a heat sink this big. I probably attach it to a lawnmower and probably like cool it off. And don't scratch the black. I like this black thing. Put it in there. It's a little sharp. And wow. It's called sharp. Why don't focus? It doesn't focus. It just doesn't want to focus. Well, you know what that is? That's like a Hi-8. Looks like a cassette tape. Like an audio cassette tape you put in here. And this thing's really cool. It's like really mechanical and electric. You put it in there, it goes and it sucks all in, like closes the lid for you and everything like that. But antiquated. And that's that thing I've been playing with. The mags and such. So my dad had this exact car and this exact color. That's cool. I just picked this up. It was a cheap toy in Rite Aid. So now I'm looking to put this in the car for my phone. Look at that. That's really cool. Move it anywhere you want. But it needs to be below 70 degrees in the car. And it's been up in the hundreds. At least 140. That's not good. Extra speakers, all right, the bed, extra speakers too. Perfect. Video games, cars, stereo words, knives, well, just fun stuff. Sega Genesis games. I got my Sega Genesis in a bottom bag, Nintendo on the top. What the hell is in this other one? Oh no, that's the Sega Genesis. There it is. I don't know. Something in there. Sansui television. My parents thought I was nuts keeping this thing in the room. It's really, really heavy. But, you know, when you play the vintage video games, that's what you want. There's actually a piece of lava right here. Made into a friggin' cigarette lighter. I don't believe in smoking cigarettes at all. And when you read the bottom, it says Coco Joe, Hawaii. Because my parents lived in Hawaii. Got some German over here too. That's cool. Would I drink out of this thing? No. I modified this 13-inch television with this speaker. It's really, really good speaker. Fucking blasts. So I got this Toshiba. It doesn't accept many programs. It doesn't even want Google Chrome. So, it is what it is. I leave it closed. I use a virtual keyboard to type in what I want. And I got this monitor from my grandmother's house. She had like a granny computer that had a computer attached to the back of it. Kind of like piggybacking off of it. And they wanted money from senior citizens just to use the internet. Now, like, the internet didn't cost anything either, right? So you got like 3 bills. So I removed the whole computer thing off of it. I got this thing to go full screen. And I'll show it to you in a minute. Yeah, so as you see, I got the monitor turned off. The keyboard does nothing. The lid does nothing. I can literally just close this. It'll stay just fine. It'll stay right on. Got a subwoofer attached to it. I got 3 different size subwoofers. This is my smallest one. You know, because in a small room, you know, my mom's the next room. That's my favorite bowling ball over there. Got me so many strikes. Unbelievable. And I hate to admit this, but I never bought this ball. Actually, I found it in the trash because for a while there, there's people either passing away or moving out, and they're like, get rid of that big hunk of shit. But this has perfect. they did it really right. For some reason, this ball is just fucking perfect for me, so I can't argue. And brand new sandals, I haven't worn yet. So I have to type my code in manually before I can use a virtual keyboard, so let me do that. So this is what I purchased from PC Richards. It's a Yamaha AX-V385. And it reminds me of something from the 90s. It's like exactly what I wanted. It's under 300 watts. It's good for the most normal, you know, living room there is. This is not the White House. And it's full surround, which I don't have in the room, so yeah, I can't put surround sound in the bedroom, but it's worth purchasing this because I could always use it somewhere else if I had to. You know, except the subwoofer. This is what I'm looking for. When I was in the store, I pulled it back. And the worker said, you need any help? And I said, no, because I can answer all my own questions just by looking at the back of it. And I like the professional twisties instead of the push jobby shit. And this is actually coaxial. That is really cool. So you could actually, you know, like you have on your cable television, put an FM radio signal onto it. This is just this, and it gets all the channels. I mean, imagine if I had the antenna outside. It's like 270 watts. Just this way I needed. Inputs, this is coming from the computer. From a 1/4 inch jack going over there. It's a lengthy wire. Guess where this wire comes from? That camera right there. The yellow is supposed to be... The yellow's on the bottom. The yellow's supposed to be the video, and it was mono. It wasn't. It's not a stereo camcorder. But look how we use it today. And also these vintage Mitsubishi speakers. They're really, really strange. It actually has like inside like a honeycomb. It actually says on the front, it says honeycomb. But I still had to... Here's it. Yeah, I still had to drill a sound hole out of it. See that hole right there? Because the entire thing was encased, and the speakers didn't know how to get out of their own way, basically. So it needed some play. Very nice diaphragm. Gigantic. And it actually says, honeycomb construction. You can set it on high, plus 2, or negative 4. You know, going the other way with the bass. So the emblem fell off this one. Supposed to be down at the bottom, but it's over there. The Mitsubishi is over there. There it is. Sorry about that flatulence before. That's the animal with my bed. I've had it for a while. Holy shit. Yeah, it wants to be fed, so I have to go, bro. I have to go, guys. See ya.